Hello, Lerier. Welcome back to Path of Exile. We are playing the Hardcore Breach League. And we are gonna go into the Belly of the Beast today. We're gonna go after Malachai. But first, we have a breach. So, last episode we picked up Obliteration, which has a 20% chance to cause enemies that I kill to explode. And I wondered if that applied to my minion skills or not. I'm not entirely sure yet. I'm not seeing as many explosions as I would expect. Okay, I'm not happy here, to be honest. Minions, surround me. Protect me. But I think I did see some explosions. But with all the minions running about and all the effects going on and off, it's really, really hard to see what the heck is happening with this build. So I'm just gonna run around with it, because the old wand we were using, all it did for us was give us a little bit of mana regen. And that didn't really do a lot. There's some conflicting information. So, enemies you kill implies, if you read it as just a... as you would read any English, you would read it as enemies you personally kill. In that case, no, you wouldn't expect enemies to explode in clouds of chaos. On the other hand, on the wiki at the kill page, it mentions that kills from minions transfer to you. So I think it's one of those things that maybe originally it started out as something that was actually internally consistent. So maybe all minion kills did transfer to you. Maybe now it's on a case by case basis. So, either way, we're just running around with a fancy, unique wand that might not even give us any benefits. But it's fun running around with it anyway. For the odd chance that we end up killing something with Desecrate, which does have a little bit of a degen component. Well, little, it's 200 life per second now. Then, of course, that has a 20% chance to trigger an explosion. And, oh, I do have a habit of battle casting Desecrate more now. So we might see some purple puffs of smoke popping up every once in a while. Got a suspicion we're running to the Bone Queen now. Yeah, the Bone Queen's gonna be up there. Hello, here. Let me teleport some minions for you. Summon the Army of the Damned. And then there's gonna be a lot of enemy minions here as well to recharge us back up full before we run into the breach that I spotted on the other side of the wall. We are still, well, actually, slightly misjudged that one. We're only half filled. That means we cast it a bit later. Oh, it's slightly further. So it's good. It's all good. Yes. Kill the rares. Oh. Interesting. Let's do the strongbox first. It's more rarity, Ice Nova, 3 rares, and a chest level. Let's just attack it from this front. But it does get our um, Army of the Damned fully charged, which is good. There's someone who ran away, of course. Cowards. And that's that. The Army of the Damned, some did early, some did often. That's basically how that goes. Similarly for raising Spectres. Summon them early, resummon them often. Though with all the corrupting blood going on here, it's not a luxury to recast them often. No, it just shakes off the regen, helps a bit. Or the degen, I should say. Shakes off the degen, not the regen. Let's see, nothing interesting got dropped here, and then I'll just pick up some of the smaller items and then call that and move on. Oop. Minions to my aid. Okay, while dealing with stragglers, might as well open up another box. Wasn't too exciting in terms of loot drops. And we push forward. Minions, once again, to my aid. So, those Eye Summoner portals, I believe it was one of those, though they have a habit of doing rather significant damage, especially because they place those mines underneath your feet and they're hard to see, especially when there's just a lot of stuff going on. Oh, and then there's another breach. Waha! Yeah. Breach rares Ghost might be tempting fate here, but, well, be a good opportunity, wouldn't it? There's a large vortex over there, but it was a bit too far away for us, which is okay. I'm perfectly fine missing out on some things if it means, no, just gobbling up the loot that does drop and surviving the encounter. And there we are, Belly of the Beast level 2. Made a little bit of a beachhead for us here. Means we can push onwards. And there's another breach. Nice. Now, killing a couple more enemies before that does mean we have more souls in our Army of the Damned. The Damned going up. Class that, they want it. Okay. And it seems like though there's not many more enemies coming in, which is too bad. This is dead end. That also doesn't help. Let's head to the top left. Seem to have decent luck with that. Let's see. Strongbox. I had three over there. Those are the ones placing mines. Well, if there's a lot of minions waltzing in first, minions have a chance of attracting the wrath of the eye rather than me myself. Ooh, rogue exile and it explodes. Also, someone ate a zombie. This time I'm having a bit of a harder time pointing out exactly who it was, but either way, they should be ashamed of themselves. Ah, Agostina Solaria. Very recognizable from her spectral weapons. And we get our very, very first map drop. It's only level 56 here. Level 58 monster. But we did get it. Jungle Valley. So that's good. I actually have to start a tab now for tier 1 or for lower tier maps. Which is good. I didn't expect it to need that until Merciless. And then the later parts of Merciless rather than the earlier parts. But it's always good. So for this league with maps, I'm not gonna follow the same method I took last league. Last league I had two different characters that I divided between one character gets the left side, other character gets the right side of the tree. And that way both series would have different maps going for them. This league I'm just running one character. So it's very nice and easy to just have a single mapping pool. No division, so I'm just gonna play whatever. I'm also not gonna insist on doing every map while recording. Because there's nothing truly new about the maps anymore. That was last season, all maps got overhauled. This season, or this league I should say, or this patch or expansion or whatever you want to call it. The maps are not the new thing, it's some of the skills. So I will be advancing things, I'll be recording all the maps I do playthrough, but if a map playthrough is not going to be particularly interesting, then I'll just continue playing and do the next one and the next one and the next one. So there might be gaps, so it could be that one day I'll be playing two at once. Next day could be do a tier 2 or tier 3. And I might be shifting things a little bit. I'm gonna try to avoid doing duplicates. Ooh, there's a lot of things going on here. Give me that shrine. Courage, stand tall. Oh yeah. I do like it when the wither gets really, really large. Cover everything. Also, we get an increase to the number of zombies and skeletons here. Oh yeah, and 20% increased damage. That's maybe even better. But my playstyle for the maps is gonna be that every map I'm gonna run, I'm gonna play it as white first. Then I'm gonna play it as a blue. Then I'm gonna play it as a yellow. And then I'm gonna play it as a Vile Jello. The rare and Vile rare I'm gonna skip for the lower tier map, so I'm gonna do white first and then blue. And I'm gonna be very, very careful in playing the maps and advancing the maps. So first, especially because on the right-hand side of the tree, I haven't played all the lower and medium tier maps yet. So they are going to be, well, dangerous because they are an unknown factor for me. On the left-hand side of the tree, there are a lot of maps I've already played. So that's going to be, well, if I've played maps already before dozens of times. And of course, I'm going to be familiar with the fights, I'm going to know what to expect. But I'm going to take things rather slowly. That's also why I'm not recording every map for YouTube. Or at least I'm recording it, but I'm not going to release it. Because, you know, going through a tier where just plain white map is going to be easy / boring. But it's going to be safe. Piety and Caustic Clouds, it's a match made in heaven. Okay, let's get our minions back up, and there we go. That was Piety. Well, once she hits you, she does take a chunk out of your energy shield, which is fair, but if that's only the one time, you know, you just fix the corrupted blood off. And then you just focus on putting corpses underneath her feet and turning them into specters, and doing that a couple times in order to get some caustic clouds going. You don't really need a lot in order to take her out. Malachai is going to be a bit of a different story. His life pool is a lot larger, so we can't easily do that to him, but well. That's why we have minions that are punching and clawing and gnawing and whatever else minions do in these days. Let's see. We just summon minions here, do some a little bit of telefragging, and life is good. And let's see who rolled up on this side of the map this time. I remember normal Malachai and friends being very, very doable. So let's see if it has changed a bit on Cruel, or if we are still rather powerful compared to them. Hey, you. Yes, you. Let's have a look. So, Maligaro is gonna be up first. Arguably bit of an annoying guy, but given the large number of minions we have, this is probably gonna be one of the most doable fights. A body to kill for. Just keep resummoning our minions on top of him. And that's it. So we get another jungle valley.
I hate to be critical, but I've seen better.
So we are so full that we couldn't even pick up his heart. So we'll just empty our pockets here. All the other gems and maps and things that we got here. And then we simply go back and pick up whatever he dropped. And then we nicely take the portal back to the waypoint, because that is still faster. Here, Piety, you hold on to this one. And we're gonna run the other way. Okay. Don't have a mine underneath my feet yet. Disappointing. I'm slightly disappointed about you, eye hatchery. Daedra's Arena. Okay, let's pick one side so we only get affected by a single curse. We just take a step back here. Put some corpses underneath her feet and just turn them into specters again. Also re-summoning the golem a little bit. I haven't done extensive math on whether at this point the golem or the minions would give you or the specters would give you the most damage, so I'm just trying to alternate them a little bit. So in the end the cosmic cloud that does the most damage is gonna be the one that takes effect. It's similar to how burning works in that regard. And how bleeding works and how all other damage over time effects work. Except of course poison, because poison stacks. Well, burning, or specifically I think ignite, also stacks if you use the Ember Wake Ring, but that's getting into very, very specific territory. Hello, big guy. Doomshiver! Yes, you please die. You as well, get out of my back. And then we can just push onwards. There are minions here. And then suddenly, there's not a lot of them anymore. Breaches are rather inconsistent in that regard. And nothing interrupts back there. Time to move on to the next arena. Which ought to be somewhere around, slightly further than here. Okay, step back from the mines. I actually spotted it this time. Whoop, another one. And it's not gonna spawn any mines no more. Our minions are all still in good health. Chevron is gonna make a change of that, of course. Let's get out of the books. This is a sort of wisdom that can actually hurt you. And there we are. Two sets of entrails. I might as well portal back, empty our pockets, then go into the Malachai fight clean. With nothing to lose except for the stuff we are equipping. Yes, and I actually remembered to use the portal rather than the waypoint. So, on the black core, here we go.
You and I are about to create the most beautiful of nightmares together. Will you go to bed now, girl? Or do I need to tuck you in?
Now, Exile!
Okay. So already precasting corpses there. Turning them all into nice bits of chaos. So, first stage. Get your tentacles away from me, please. So, Piety is
now Exile.
Next stage, good. We're gonna go for Malachai. Golem, please trigger some mines for me, will ya? Piety is gone. Also, the golem, not the golems, the zombies, they seem to be gone as well. Well, first stage we did manage to do without really taking a lot of damage. Army of the Damned isn't fully charged, but
could have thought you'd be so.
Now, let us see if you truly understand what it means to be Nightmare.
Okay. He is gonna appear behind me. Like that. So he already has his first stage up. I completely overlooked this one. It goes rather quickly with a minion build. Okay, minions, please teleport over here and be regenerated a little bit. Next stage of Malachai, he's gonna appear here and we get out, because we don't want to get hit by his teleport attack. Similarly to how he doesn't really fancy my teleport attack. We still have all our numbers up. The army still marches. Hello. Here, let me teleport some minions to you. That's gonna be lovely. Okay, second heart. Teleport minions in again. Let's see, just summon some. Yeah, see? Cost the clouds, they work. They work a lot.
You are being selfish.
Are you being shellfish? What? Let's get out. I'm not the only one that likes degen here. Malachai is also a big fan of using that to good effect. He disappeared, but in this case he disappeared to the other side of the map. Oh, let's summon the army. Oh. And final stage. And we can just resummon a couple of minions here, get some cost of clouds going, and then the clouds will finish this for us. You, there you go. Yeah. I'll Tunnel-Frank you. And then I can't even see him anymore because there's just so much stuff happening here. Teleport minions in. And that was Malachai. So, currently level 63. This is a 57 area that makes Malachai himself 59. So slightly overleveled. But that is the way to deal with content. Make safe. A better safe than dead. And Path of Exile is especially punishing if you are not prepared.
They all leave me.
Let's see. Ooh, we got some gems. It's actually not bad. Cast one stunt. You are stunned or block a stunning hit. Interesting. That would be if you're leaning heavily towards energy shields rather than a hybrid, a Castman stunt might be interesting. Or if you're doing a full block build. For us though, doesn't really matter, we'll just pick up minion speed here. Because it's a minion. And then, Merciless is for us. And yeah, might as well just walk forward, right? Go to town.
Soon rise for me, not against me.
Hello, goodbye. Let's see, how are resistances? So, cold is pretty decent, 64. Fire is at 36. Lightning 55, and chaos negative 19. So, we do need to focus a bit more on our chaos resistance here. At least getting into positive territory. And then raising our other resistances to be maxed. Preferably before the end of Act 1. Of course, next episode is gonna be the labyrinth. So, no, a labyrinth. Arcanist. We're gonna be back in Cruel. Our resists are gonna be in good shape. Ooh, Arcanist strongbox. You always want to run with something useful on top. So, let's quickly take. You know, just take a stack of all, whatever. That'd be really easier. Increase quantity. 43% increased quantity, is that useful? Yeah, we'll go for it. Let's see. Freeze removal, that works rather well. And then over there. Ta-da! Open 100 strong boxes. We are triggering achievements today, aren't we? I like it. And then, hello, Hillock. Here, have an army of the damned on your face. Also, boom. I doubt he had a chance to pull that sword from his belly. Yeah, poor Hillock. Everybody always just waltzes over him. And we get a ring, so we'll grab fire, I guess. And with that, we have reached merciless difficulty. So, as always, we're gonna thank you very much for watching. And I hope to see you again next time. Bye-bye.